Comedian Dan Ilic has taken his cheeky humour to the world, as we saw in New York last week. He's behind a 10-minute scathingly satirical climate change message to the Prime Minister via massive billboards in Times Square. 5 hours later, ScoMo announced he'd be attending next month's climate summit in Glasgow.
Wow. So,
yeah, it's good, huh? Please welcome clearly Australia's most powerful person, Dan Ilic, from his car on the side of the road somewhere in Sydney. He's changed his mind.
He's
out of the car. He's into the studio. How are you, Dan?
Yes. I managed to get into my studio. I'm very well. Thanks for letting me come and bestow my power upon you. It's good to be here.
It's great to have you here. Tell us, how did you come up with this idea?
You know what? I was just thinking about what can we do in the lead up to Glasgow to bring shame upon Australia's government for their complete lack of climate action over the last 13 years. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to put a billboard in Glasgow. I bought it. It's going to cost me $12,000. And I thought, well, I don't necessarily want to pay it for myself. I'll see if other people want to help out. And so I asked my listeners of my podcast to chip in, and I put it on Indiegogo. And 2 hours later, I got $12,000. And then the money kept coming in. So I'm like, well, I'm going to need to put more billboards in more places. So I upgraded to a bigger billboard in Glasgow. And then I've bought billboards in Barnaby Joyce's electorate, Josh Frydenberg's electorate, Horsham, the Great Ocean Road. And then I thought, well, you know, I might as well, as the money kept coming in, I thought I might as well buy the biggest billboard quite that is possible. And we bought the Times Square's biggest billboard and to shame the government in the most public way possible in Times Square. And we managed to do that. We even got on CNN. I was on Jake Tapper's show. It was amazing. Beamed around the world.
But, mate, what was the cost of Times Square? Because we all know how expensive billboards are. That is prime position anywhere in the world. What was the cost of that?
You know, it's just about a day rate for me, so not too. You know, it costs $100,000 an hour to book in Times Square. But I did a deal. I did a deal in Times Square. I managed to get it down to $12,000 for 10 minutes. So I've got a sweet deal from my media buyer. It was great.
You must have been buzzing then, Dan, when you heard only a couple of hours later then that the PM, when he announced he was going to be attending the climate change summit.
Yeah, and did you notice in the press conference he said, we made a decision last night that I would go to Glasgow. And I'm like, yeah, mate, I'm sure you made that last night. I think I'm pretty sure you made that at 9:55 a.m.
Yeah. Is there more, Dan, is there more to come? Because what you've done so far has worked.
There is. I don't know if you can see this. I've got some billboards ready to go for Glasgow. This is a bit hard to read on the screen here, but I'll read it out to you. Paris targets. We meet and beat because we cheat. Australia, reducing emissions by making more emissions, which happens to be our 2050 plan.
Yeah.
And then finally, Glasgow welcomes the Prime Minister of Australia. And I'm sure Scott Morrison will be pleased to see this picture of Rupert Murdoch beaming down upon him as he drives through the streets of Glasgow.
Mate, on the world stage, we're only a drop in the ocean, but what you've done so far has worked. But, mate, I looked into it last night. I saw it on the project. And what I saw, Russia, India and China account for 40% of global emissions. Do you think there'll be similar people in your position in those nations, or will you, you know, maybe call those nations out? Because there's no real international outrage so far.
Well, what? Here's the thing. We are the third largest exporter of fossil fuels to the world. This is a supply issue for those folks. I had a wonderful friend in Korea compliment the billboards, and he sent me a picture of his sky, which had no smoke in it at all. And he said, Dan, because of the Australia-China trade dispute last week, we haven't had any smoke in our sky. That's in Korea. Wow. We have to put in perspective that the coal we dig up gets put on a boat and gets sent somewhere else and gets burned and puts in the sky all around the world. It is phenomenal. And I know, you know, the China, Russia and India account for a large amount of emissions, but we are, if you count out all the coal that gets burned that we export, we are the eighth largest polluter in the world. The eighth largest polluter, if you include all the emissions from the stuff that we send on ships outside. That is phenomenal. And in total, we are the 14th largest polluter in the world.
Yeah.
So it is, you know, we might not make the top 10, but that's not a place we want to be. We are the 14th. We're the 14th largest polluter in the world for a country that is 26 million people. That is pretty sad, you know. Yeah. So we need to work on a new plan to get coal workers into new jobs to get them early retirement.
Yeah, that's the thing.
We need a new plan to expand renewables right across Australia. We could be a renewable power superpower. Mm. We could do that. We could export 800% electricity from our country, and it's totally possible to do.
Because as long as they're going to buy it, mate, we're going to sell it. But, mate, just we're running out of time here now. Tell us real quickly about your podcast, Irrational Fear. It's going gangbusters.
Irrational Fear, it's right here, yes. And it is, oh, here we go. It's Australia's favourite comedy podcast.
Good
here we
job.
Go. Comedy podcast award there. Listen to irrationalfear.com. Check out the podcast. It's really great. This week we actually have Joe Hildebrand on, and we mock him for 40 minutes.
What a man.
And, I know he's really been missed being mocked, having left Studio 10. Yeah. So it is just great to have him back on in a space where he can be gently mocked and niggled. And
well, we love him and miss him, mate.
He's doing great work along with yourself. That's fantastic. Check it out at irrationalfear.substack.com. Dan, thanks so much for joining us.
Good job.
Great to be with you.
Take care. All the best.